Hey, you guys. It's simple. Supper tonight. Let's eat. Baloney sandwich. Making and eating baloney sandwich. And Halloween tale or two. things that I'll remember my whole life. We always went with our best friends from our street. We lived like in a good traditional Southern California tract home. And we would go trick-or-treating and we'd get tons of candy because there was like several streets in the tract and everybody went out for Halloween. Everybody got a ton of candy. My purple lipstick already wore off. Not happy about the dark purple lipstick from the Spirit Halloween store, FYI. So I wouldn't waste your money on it. It's about $4. She was always good. Mom and Dad were both always good to just have tons of candy for the trick-or-treaters that came and would take us out. And there was always one parent with us and one parent at home to hand out the candy. It was just a ton of fun. Okay, so no pillowcase ever. And then it was like a horror if you found a homemade baked goodie item in your treat bag. I'll never forget, back then some houses would hand out popcorn balls. And when we'd see them put it in our trick-or-treat bag, we were terrified that either it was going to have a needle. And then there were the people that made homemade brownies and put a homemade brownie in there. Same thing. Horror. It was like we came running down from that house, grabbing the homemade item in our hand. And Mom, look. So my mom would take it right away so we wouldn't eat it and kill ourselves. And the biggest fun were the families, believe it or not, made candied apples. Everybody got a candied apple wrapped up in like a nice fellow cellophane wrapper. Was hysterical. There were actual people who just had bowls of apples, green and red, and they'd let you pick, do you want a green or red apple? It was like so confusing for me as a kid, I didn't understand it, but anyways, I'm thinking, don't they know nobody's gonna eat your apple, because we all think in there. And what was the other item? was the year where the actual candy from the, you know, the grocery store. Let's say, for example, the Snickers bar or the Milky Way or Almond Joy, or you'd get the little Halloween pieces. There was that horrible year where someone found a needle in one of the prepackaged traditional Halloween chocolate candies. Which, you know, now that I think about it, it's very easy to do. I'll never forget that when that happened. So then we had to have a parent patrol over every chocolate bar. They would sort out our candy, right? The stuff they the stuff that mom definitely knew. Couldn't have like a killer razor needle, and so it'd be separated, the fun chocolate versus the boring candy. And I think what it came down to was you know, mom just kind of inspected it. You have to be careful when you eat this. Anyways. Oh, it just is such good times, you know. This is growing up in Simi Valley, California. Back then, the far side of Simi Valley, the east side, which was known as Santa Susana. I know in this year of 2020, I know 2020 vision or 2020 hindsight, I'm spending a lot of time enjoying fun childhood memories. Bread. One of them. National Bologna Days, October 24th of this year. So that's why I decided to do Bologna sandwich.